Unanimous consent that the quorum call be dispensed with?
Without objection.
Madam President, as our nation's war against the coronavirus has waged on, the Senate has taken decisive action to provide the resources we need to win the fight. We've sent critical equipment to our frontline healthcare workers, and we've expanded testing resources nationwide. We provided loans to small businesses in order to protect jobs, and we sent direct financial assistance to the Americans who are struggling the hardest to make ends meet. These four bills, now laws, passed by Congress, have addressed both the public health crisis at the heart of the pandemic and the ensuing economic fallout. Now, with the states beginning to gradually reopen their economies, we're staring down the barrel of a second epidemic, one generated by opportunistic lawsuits, crushing legal fees, and drawn-out court battles. According to a database compiled by the law firm Hunt and Andrews Kurth, more than 950 such lawsuits have already been filed in the United States. We've seen suits against healthcare workers, nursing homes, colleges, governments, retailers, you name it. As our economy begins to reopen, unfortunately, so will the legal floodgates. The litigation epidemic is shaping up to be a big one. But don't get me wrong, Madam President, lawyers aren't all bad. I confess to being one myself. And there will no doubt be some meritorious claims. But many suits potentially serve as a cash cow, a chance to shake down a business for a nuisance settlement due to the cost alone of defending a lawsuit, even if you win. With a pandemic that has affected more than 1 million Americans, you better believe there are some preparing for a gold rush. You can hear the TV commercials now, asking if you or a loved one were impacted by the coronavirus, encouraging you to call a 1-800 number to see if you could be entitled to some money. Imagine you're a nurse who's being sued by the family of a patient who tragically passed away at your hospital. Even though you acted in good faith and you took every precaution to save the life of the patient, you could get pulled into a nightmarish legal fight over a case that ends up having no merit in the first place. Or let's say you're a small business owner who closed your doors at the start of the pandemic, but then you've applied for the loans, you've done everything in your power to stay afloat until you could reopen. When that time comes, you take every precaution. Your employees wear masks, you reduce the number of customers so as to provide for social distancing, you regularly clean your store and have hand sanitizer available for all employees and customers. But then somebody says they contracted the virus in your store and they're going to sue you. Well, I have no doubt, Madam President, that unless we provide for some limitations, there will be businesses that will say, why bother? Why take on the risk? It's just not worth it. Small businesses, we know, provide the lion's share of the jobs in our economy, and they could get roped into spending all their savings, what's left, to defend or settle a nuisance lawsuit. And the fear of these consequences could worsen the toll this crisis has already taken on our economy. We simply cannot allow a flood of frivolous lawsuits to harm our incredible health care workers or stunt our economic recovery. As we speak, Madam President, I'm working with colleagues on legislation to address the anticipated lawsuit bonanza. Let me be clear. Not all lawsuits are created equal. Without a doubt, there will be legitimate claims as a result of reckless wrongdoing in the wake of this pandemic. And those are the types of cases we want to make sure are heard. Last week, the Utah Daily Herald reported that one business required staff who tested positive for the COVID-19 to report to work anyway. Almost half of the business's employees tested positive. Now, you don't have to be Perry Mason or Matlock, and I realize I'm dating myself here, to see that this is an egregious violation of federal guidelines. There's no desire to impede the effort to hold bad actors accountable. Period. That's my guiding principle. The problem is with the with the expected onslaught of frivolous claims, which will do nothing more than harm the very people already hurt by this virus. Just because a lawsuit is baseless doesn't mean it will be quick, easy, or cheap to resolve. And we can't put our healthcare workers in a situation where, after battling this virus for months on end, they then have to battle a false claim in court. Future legislation should include liability protections for our frontline workers and small businesses who are complying with the very government regulations designed to protect against the spread of the virus. More than a dozen governors have already provided liability protections to healthcare workers, but we can't just depend on the states to uphold these protections, and we can't wait for the dam to break. Congress must act to provide this shield for the healthcare workers that have done everything in their power to save lives during this unprecedented crisis. Again, to state the obvious, this would not interfere with liability for intentional or grossly negligent conduct. As I said before, no one wants to put a stop to meritorious lawsuits. We want to prevent baseless claims from tying up our courts, destroying jobs, and holding our economy hostage. There are several ways to accomplish this, but we need to focus on a solution that provides clarity for our businesses and prevents gamesmanship in the courts. Michael Krauss is a law professor at George Mason University who specializes in tort law. He has pointed out that employees can get workers' compensation benefits if they become sick or disabled on the job. In other words, employees will be covered by existing workers' compensation laws. So now what we're talking about is third-party claims, not employees. But defending lawsuits, no matter how far-fetched, is expensive, and litigation costs alone can make the difference between the destruction and the survival of a business. Professor Krauss has said that, in his opinion, the ideal statute would say, if you do the following, you may not be sued. He said that could include a list of requirements like wearing masks. There could be specific regulations for restaurants, for meat packers, or other industries. Any liability limitations will only protect the individuals or companies who comply with those guidelines and who seek to keep their workers and the public safe. My colleagues and I have been in discussion about the best way to do this, and we're actively developing a proposal that I hope will gain bipartisan support. There are fair and reasonable ways to deal with this. We've seen this before. This is not a novel concept, whether it's in response to the Y2K paranoia around the turn of the century or the attacks of 9/11. And there are many, many more examples where Congress has, on a bipartisan basis, responded to a national emergency and provided these sort of common sense legal protections. As we continue to work to support the American people during the crisis we are facing today, we can't ignore the onslaught of lawsuits that could soon bankrupt small businesses and strangle our recovering economy. Congress must act to ensure America doesn't wake up from this pandemic only to find it in a legal nightmare that we could and should have prevented. Madam President, I yield the floor.